You gain some insight from looking at a tridiagonal matrix, and you now understand how to take advantage of the zeros in such a matrix. Let's move on to the matrix that came from the five-point stencil that we looked at in the launch. That matrix would look like this. And what we notice is that below this subdiagonal there are zeros, and above this superdiagonal there are zeros. And maybe we could take advantage of those as well, ignoring any zeros in between. And by the way, this matrix too can be shown to be symmetric positive definite, so the Cholesky factorization would be appropriate. Now let's get away from this specific example and look at a general symmetric positive definite matrix that has some kind of bounded structure. So here we have a matrix where each x indicates some value that may or may not be zero, but all other values are equal to zero. And this particular matrix has a bandwidth of 3, so the number of diagonals and subdiagonals that have non-zeros in them is the bandwidth. In general, the bandwidth would be given by B, so in this case B is equal to 3. And you would hope that here too one could take advantage of the special structure when performing a Cholesky factorization. So your homework is to design an algorithm that actually does take advantage of the zeros of the bounded structure of the matrix, and to then analyze what its cost is so that you can compare that to the cost if you had simply ignored the zeros and done it as if it's a dense matrix.